I'll be doing shit I really shouldn't do for real. That's why I always take them through for real. After this time, I'll be through for real.
Alright, guys, just checking in because I'm about to go to a sneaker ball, my aunt's sneaker ball baby shower. A lot, I know, but I'll check back in when I get there, and yeah. Lashes are off, tight scrunchie is out, and we are about to get out of these clothes before we start our skincare. Don't want to mess my dress up, but yes, I'm going to take you guys along with me for my nighttime routine. So excited. All right, guys, we are back. About to put my little scrunchies on my wrist so no water gets anywhere it doesn't need to be. We are actually going to be starting with the Verst Day Dissolve Cleansing Balm with eucalyptus oil and vitamin E. I like this a lot. It is one of those situations where you have to like wet your face first and the balm like dissolves in your hand, of course, with the warmth, and you just rub it on your makeup or whatever you have on for that day to wash the day off. More warm water. I tend to use a lot of this though when I have makeup on, just so I'm making sure that it gets completely off my face. Usually with this, instead of like other cleansing balms or things that take your makeup off, it can be very stripping to your skin. But this, I think it's the vitamin E in it. It's very moisturizing. Like, yes, you have a fresh face feel, but it's also moisturized, if that makes sense. And like I said before, I like to wet my face first before using the cleansing balm. So we're gonna start. Then I like to go over it a second time just to ensure that I got all of the makeup off. And we are all makeup free. Next, we are going to go in with my favorite. I know I say that a lot, but this is genuinely my favorite cleanser. So, the La Roche-Posay Purifying Foaming Cleanser. And now now that we are all double cleansed, we are going to tone our face with the hydrating milky toner, snow mushroom, and hydrochloric acid. Yes, and it is the Theirs brand, so. And just using a regular cotton pad. I like to fill up the whole cotton pad. Now, if you do use this one specifically, do not be alarmed by the like slimy texture of it. I think that helps and aids in it being so hydrating, honestly. Yes, and it is a toner, so it is getting the rest of the dirt and gunk off of your face. And then I just usually wait for this to dry. And once my face feels like almost sticky, I like to go in with my Peter Thomas Roth Potency Power Brightening Hydrogel Eye Patches. It's basically like an eye mask for under your eye, but a brightening one. I use the de-puffing ones in the morning by the same brand. So the eye. I got this idea off of TikTok. It's supposed to make sure that the towel doesn't slip by folding it outward instead of, you know, just tucking it. So far, not really working. And then at night, because who doesn't love a little bit of skincare and self-care, I like to also put on a lip mask. I have two. One is a brightening one and one is a hydrating one with aloe. I think I'm going to use the aloe one today, but either way, I have to let them both sit for 10 minutes. So I'm going to check back in with you guys in 10 minutes and we'll continue with our skincare routine. We are all done with our lip and eye mask, but we can just take these off and throw them away. Okay, so next I like to use like hydrating mist before I use my serum. The first one is the Pixi Milky Hydrating Mist. Hydrating Milky Mist. And the second is the Mario Badescu Facial Spray with aloe, chamomile, and lavender. I like this one because it gives me like nighttime getting ready for bed vibes. So it's going to like wind you down as well. I like that. I like to start with the hydrating mist one. I use a lot of this, I know. But because it comes out as a mist, I feel like I don't get a lot of it when I spray. So, I do spray it a lot. And then now for the second. Oh, it smells so good. And then I like to let my face dry just a little because I like my serums to go on while my face is still moist. I don't know, I think it penetrates better for me. But for toner, I have the Good Molecules Discoloration Correcting Serum. This is a really good serum so far. I have been seeing my dark spots lighten since I've been using this. So I really, really do like it so far. And then pat. Yes. Okay, so next We have eye creams. I have an overnight eye cream by OOTD. It has peptides, vitamin C, and collagen in it. It has one of these applicators, which I love, so I don't have to touch it. I can kind of just dot it along my under eye, like so. And then I like to use my ring finger to rub it in. And I go over my eye as well. Yes. And then I like to do like another lip mask in addition to the other one that I did. This is the Neutrogena Hydrating Lip Sleeping Mask Hydro Boost. So far, I've gotten this probably like 2-3 days ago. Love it. I am in love with this. And it's so moisturizing. You can see it right off of the gate. And as you can see, super moisturizing. Last but certainly not least, we are going in with our La Roche-Posay Double Repair Face Moisturizer. I like to use this at night as well. I just feel like it's that good that I can use it at night and in the morning to make sure that my face is super moisturizing. Now at night, I do like to pack it on because it's nighttime and you want your face to be super moisturized, because I don't know, I just get a feeling that at night my face loses moisture, you know, tossing and turning in your pillow. I feel like your pillow is getting and picking up most of the moisture. So I like to pack it on just in case that happens to be so. And that is the finished product. Yes, all glowy and clean now. So I do like to do a little something to my hair because it is nighttime, and why not? Oh, I also got this pillow scrunchie thingy from Five Below. Obsessed. Obsessed. So first I'm going in with the Miel Sea Moss, the Miel Organics Anti-Shedding Scalp and Hair Oil. I like to put this just around my edges to make sure that they stay moisturized. I use the tips of my fingers or the balls of my fingers to rub it in. Then I like to go in with the Shea Moisture Coconut and Hibiscus Smooth and Shine Oil with Minetti and Neem Oil. I still have to fact check that and see if I'm saying it right. I doubt that I am, though. But it claims to be moisturizing, it softens, it is 24-hour frizz control, and also a heat protectant. So that's really what got me into it, the heat protectant part, because why not protect your hair at all times? I use 2 little squirts, and then I put this in the remaining part of my hair, especially the back where I have it colored at, because I don't need that drying out. Then I do have some shed here. If you have any treatments for like super shedding hair, please leave them in the comment box below. I need all of the help that I can get, please. We go in with our pillow scrunchie because I love it. Put everything to the back again so that I can continue my slick back if I wanted to. I like to grab my soft brush and then the hard brush. And then we put it up
then just a itty bitty bun for the shower.
Doesn't have to be perfect. Then I'm going to take my little edge scarf and make sure my edges are protected. But not least, every black girl has a bonnet. As for our skin and hair routine at night, we are about to hop in the shower. I am going to hop in real fast to show you guys what I'm going to be using in the shower. And I will see you guys when I get out. All right, guys, we are back. I just wanted to show you guys what I will be using while I'm in the shower. First, I'm going to be using the Method Body Hydrating Body Wash in coconut milk. And then second, I'm going to be mixing them together. I like to do that. The Naturium The Smoother Glycolic Acid Body Wash. It states that it gently exfoliates, resurfaces to reveal softer, smoother skin. And it is exfoliating day for me because I like to do it at least twice a week to make sure that my skin is all soft and supple, of course. Then I will be going in with the First Aid Beauty KP Bump Eraser Body Scrub with 10% AH, safe for sensitive skin. I don't think I showed you guys the Naturium. And then lastly, for feminine wash for down there, I like to use the L Brand Foam Wash, no fragrances, sulfates, or parabens with vitamin E. And I will be putting on, of course, something very cozy. Just some shorts that I got from Aerie. They're like gym shorts. I'm pretty sure you could wear them outside if you wanted to, but I like to wear them as loungewear. Also, some regular just socks. And I also have a huge t-shirt because what girl doesn't love to lounge in a huge t-shirt? It is by a brand that made me this named AIP. So, yeah, it's like super cute. It has a little winky face and then three stripes on the arm sleeve. Super cute. But I am about to hop in the shower. We'll check back in with you guys when I'm out of the shower just to show you guys what I'm going to be moisturizing with, of course. Let's hop in the shower. Gotta fight with me at Cheesecake, you fight with me at Cheesecake, you why you gotta fight with me at Cheesecake, you fight with me at Cheesecake, you why you gotta fight with me at Cheesecake, you fight with me at Cheesecake, you why you gotta fight with me at Cheesecake, you fight with me at Cheesecake, you fight with me, fight with me, fight with me at you, fight with me. All right, guys, shower is over and done with. Now we are about to moisturize our body. First, we are going to start off with the Osea Underdaria Algae Body Oil. So far, this has been awesome. It is so moisturizing and it smells amazing. Love it, love it, love it, love it. Especially it mixed with this, the Eau Shea Butter 24 Hour Moisture Body Lotion in Vanilla Cashmere. Oh. Absolutely an amazing combo, guys. If you don't try anything else from this channel, please try this combo. I love, love, love it. Love it. And for deodorant, we are using the Native Aloe and Green Tea Aluminum Free Baking Soda Free Sensitive Version.
I like this as well. I only use Native. I have been trying a lot of the sensitive scents because my underarms can be a bit sensitive. So yes, for our kitty area and our back area, we will be using the fur oil. This has been amazing and it has been a key staple for my shaving routine to make sure I have no razor bumps. It has been working wonders, honestly. And I'm trying something new with my stretch marks. I wanted to get rid of a few of them in some areas, so I will be using the bio oil, skincare oil. I hear a lot of pregnant mothers live by this. Basically, it's a staple for them in making sure their stretch marks go away after labor and everything. So I wanted to try it out on mine. So that is our moisturizing routine. I will check back in with you guys when we are feeding the fur babies dinner. Gotta fight with me at cheesecake. Fight with me at cheesecake. Why you gotta fight with me at cheesecake? You fight with me at cheesecake. You why you gotta fight with me at cheesecake? You fight with me at cheesecake. You why you gotta fight with me at cheesecake? You fight with me at cheesecake. You fight with me at cheesecake. Fight with me, fight with me, fight with me at cheesecake. Fight with me, fight with me, fight with me, fight with me, fight with me. X on the beat. And I'm a punk, and I this time doesn't matter. For the night, a yoga flow just to get my body kind of relaxed and everything for the evening, and I'm going to bring you guys along with me. But being as though yoga is supposed to be soothing and peaceful, I'm not going to be talking. I'm going to cue some music for you guys.
Yes, I'll be there.
This is me closing out this vlog or video, blog, whatever you want to call it. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next video. Oh, sorry. I'm so tired. Ready for bed. But yes, see you guys in my next video. That's why I was to come through for real. After this time, I'll be through for real. I'll be doing shit I really shouldn't.